It's taken more than a month, but now Shanghai's leaders think this outbreak is contained. So it's time for a mass cleanup. Disinfection by an army of workers, thousands of them, before a gradual opening up. But the brutal war against COVID has left a scarred city. People as old as 100 were among those tested positive and taken to quarantine centres. One man detailed what he saw firsthand on social media.
A lot of the old people have underlying health problems, and the conditions inside quarantine centres are not good. We hope the elderly can be sent to better hospitals.
In the 5 weeks I've been locked down, you can't step outside the gates. It's Shanghai's most vulnerable who've suffered the most. Almost all the official dead are elderly and unvaccinated. China's leaders insist that still chasing zero COVID is the right thing.
The enforcement has been harsh at times. Some people barricaded into their homes or forced out of them. Communities fenced off. But Xi Jinping has made it clear there's no change. The man in charge of China's ruling Communist Party believes persistence is victory. This is now a test of China's way, of his credibility. One part of China has changed tack, though.
Well, in Hong Kong, we never did a total lockdown. Schools were closed, a lot of people were working from home, but it was by no means a lockdown. And my concern in Shanghai would be, how long can this go on? Because the case numbers are not going to come down to zero immediately. They're going to drop down slowly, but the whole thing could happen again in a month or 2 months or 3 months if there's another outbreak of Omicron.
Debate about living with it on the mainland has been shut down in public, though, and there's little room for dissent. This man was detained by police for simply showing his shopping, some pork donated by a neighbouring province. His crime highlighting the food supply problems. The government said this small-scale, subtle protest, banging pots in parts of Shanghai, is influenced by foreign forces. China's capital is now on guard against any spread. Most of this country has been virus-free now for almost 2 years. But as Omicron threatens, renewed anxiety is spreading. Robin Brandt, BBC News in Shanghai.